And well, you better watch what you tweet these days, because Big Brother could be reading. As the Obama administration plans to double cybersecurity funding, the Department of Homeland Security now plans to monitor social media. Meanwhile, the SOPA bill that sparked outrage over online freedom, it's back, but under a new name. So, as Big Brother widens its cyber reach, what does it mean for your online freedoms? Well, to talk more about this is Ginger McCall, director of EPIC's Open Government Program and the IPIOP program. Welcome to our program, Ginger. So, DHS is now expanding their monitoring of social media, and this has civil liberty advocates concerned. Why is that?
Well, first, Department of Homeland Security does not have the legal authority to engage in the sort of monitoring that they are engaging in. It's well outside of the bounds of their statutory mandate. Second, this sort of monitoring has the very real potential to chill online speech, especially legitimate criticism and dissent against the government.
And I understand that you, you're an attorney, and your organization has filed a Freedom of Information Act to the Department of Homeland Security to get documents pertaining to social media monitoring. What was the response that you got from that?
We got no response, actually, for about 9 months, until we filed a lawsuit against the Department of Homeland Security under the Freedom of Information Act. And at that point, we received about 300 pages of documents from them detailing this program.
And I understand that you got some more documents today. Anything in there that was revealing or eye-opening or that caught your interest in terms of monitoring of social media by DHS?
What we found in these documents is that the Department of Homeland Security paid about $11 million to General Dynamics to engage in media monitoring, not just for the sort of terrorism threats or weather disaster threats that you might expect they would be monitoring, but also for reports that, quote, reflect adversely on the agency, for public reaction to policy proposals by the Department of Homeland Security and even possibly the Obama administration more broadly. And for any sort of news stories that speak positively or negatively about DHS or any of its components.
So, I mean, what does this all mean for the average citizen, the average online user? I mean, obviously, social networking sites are huge these days. Why should the average internet user be concerned about this?
Well, I think a good example of why users should care is within these documents, there was a report authored by the Department of Homeland Security to instruct the analysts, the media analysts, on what to look for. And one of the things that they held up as a good example was a summary report about public reaction to the proposal to move Guantanamo detainees to Standish, Michigan. And they were scraping information from Facebook, from Twitter, from the Washington Post comments section. There's no reason, there's no earthly reason under their particular statutory mandate why they should be doing this. It doesn't forward a national security interest. It doesn't forward any sort of safety interest. It's merely monitoring for criticism and dissent.
Okay. What about the argument for an online user that's like, hey, you know, this is being blown out of proportion. You know, if they want to read about what, you know, I'm tweeting, what I'm doing today, and they're not really infringing on my, you know, my day-to-day life, that they're more looking out for things that might cause a security concern. What do you say to that argument?
If you have the government constantly looking over your shoulder, listening into what you're saying, noting that down, collecting that information, retaining it for who knows how long, it will affect the way that you speak. It will affect your ability to criticize and express dissent against the government.
So you're saying that there is the possibility that this could get out of hand?
Yes, certainly. It seems in part politically motivated. It's the Department of Homeland Security looking for anything that reflects adversely on the Department of Homeland Security. They're protecting themselves instead of protecting the American public.
And why do you think they would do that?
Well, to protect themselves, again, to protect their own interests from a public relations standpoint. But they're spending taxpayer dollars on this when they really ought to be focusing their efforts on things that will protect the American public.
Another thing, President Obama, his budget recently released doubles spending on cybersecurity. Do you think that the fears now today over cybersecurity and cyber warfare are justified?
Certainly, there's this idea that a lot of times national security fears are overblown, and that's often valid. What we see again and again in the national security realm is that there's national security theater. We're all told that we should be afraid of a particular incident occurring, even though statistically there's not so much of a probability of that, and then vast amounts of taxpayer money are spent on programs that surveil the people that are overly intrusive and usually outside of the statutory bounds of the agencies involved.
Now, should people these days, should they be concerned about what they are saying online in the wake of these new laws? I mean, even you as an online user, are you concerned about what you say and what you tweet and what you do put out there?
People need to push back on the Department of Homeland Security. They need to let Congress know that they're unhappy with this program and express interest in there being oversight of this program.
Ginger, thank you so much for coming on the show. That was Ginger McCall, director of EPIC's Open Government Program and IPIOP program.